Back to another video of cloud computing in AWS. In this lesson, we are going to launch an EC2 instance, and then we will enable SSH traffic via security group, and then we will configure PuTTY in Windows to access the EC2 instance in the cloud. So let us first launch a new EC2 instance. I'm going to select Linux 2 AMI. It will be T2 Micro. I will launch it in the default VPC. Later on, we will describe how we can build a default VPC. Now we need to make sure that this EC2 has a public IP address. And now we want to give this EC2 instance a tag. We will call it like demo SSH in Windows. This is just basically to keep tagging our resources so we can have better exploration of cost and so on. Now let us configure the security group. So I will call this security group SSH security group, demo SSH security group, and this is a description I like to keep in order to keep track of why I did create this security group at the first place. Now the source of the traffic at this demo here, we are going to keep it anywhere, then we click next. Now, we want to launch this EC2 instance with a new key pair because most of you now, they will be basically creating a new instance and they don't have that key pair in their machine. So you need to create a new key pair for that EC2 instance. And let us just call it SSH demo dash key. Now this is will download a PIM file to our computer. And most of the Windows users, they will face this issue that PIM file, it won't be accepted with PuTTY. So what we need to do in order to make that PIM file accepted by the PuTTY session, and we will enable to build an SSH session to our EC2 in the cloud. So if open now PuTTY Gen, it's a tool that you have installed with PuTTY. Select the PIM file, click OK. Now save a private key because this is the private key we download to our machine and give it a name. So I will call it here demo key SSH because now the key will be basically stored as a PPK file in my computer. Click save. Now, at this stage, you should have now a new file generated in your download folder with the extension PPK. Now, if you go to PuTTY, go to your EC2 instance, the one we just launched in the cloud, get the public IP address and make sure that this is the same key we just modify from PIM to PPK. And put now the username EC2 user at the public IP address. Now in the connection, we need to increase the keep alive session to 30 seconds. Then we go to SSH and from SSH auth, we will go browse and select the PPK file that we just generated in the previous step. Click OK, accept, and now you are connected. You could do now any update in the machine. You could do any steps. So this is pretty much what we need to do in order to connect to an SSH in the cloud, especially when we have a PIM file, but we don't have the PPK file. Thank you for seeing this video and see you in the next one.